Good morning, PK scholars and families. It's Ms. Hoffman again, and I'm back for another week of Read Alouds. Today is Monday, March 23rd, 2020, and I've got a brand new book for you guys today. Today we are going to be reading 10 Little Caterpillars by Bill Martin Jr. and illustrated by Lois Elert. Has anybody ever seen any caterpillars, maybe outside of your house, in the garden, at school? Caterpillars are worm-like creatures that turn into butterflies or moths. Can you guys say caterpillar? These are all different kinds, and we're going to learn more about them in the back of the book. But before we get started, I wanted to teach you some of our vocabulary words, or share with you some of our vocabulary words so that you guys can be on the lookout throughout the story, okay? So first we have the word bower. Let's see the picture, bower. Butterfly. Caterpillar. And chrysalis. So you guys be on the lookout for those four vocabulary words, and as we run into them, I will stop and share with you what they mean. Are you guys ready to get started? All right. 10 Little Caterpillars. The first little caterpillar crawled into a bower. So a bower is a shady place under a tree or flower. Say bower. This caterpillar is in the shade or bower of the flower. See, under the leaves of the flower. The second little caterpillar wriggled up a flower. There he is. He's wriggling. The third little caterpillar climbed a cabbage head. A cabbage head is a type of vegetable, leafy vegetable. So if you were a caterpillar, what kind of vegetable would you like to climb? Why would you want to climb that vegetable? I think I would like to climb a cucumber. I love cucumbers. And I love cucumbers that turn into pickles. Those are some of my favorite foods. They also have, there's a squash right here. Squash is really good too. I might climb up a squash. The fourth little caterpillar found a melon bed. Ooh, I see watermelon, musk melon, and honeydew melon. Let's see, where's the fourth little caterpillar? Is he on the honeydew melon, the musk melon, or the watermelon? Do you see him? The fifth little caterpillar sailed a garden pool. He's sailing on a leaf. The sixth little caterpillar was carried off to school. What do you think might happen to that little caterpillar when he goes to school? Seventh little caterpillar met a hungry wren. This is a wren. It's a type of bird. And look, he's looking right at the caterpillar. Oh no, I hope the wren doesn't eat him. The eighth little caterpillar was frightened by a hen. Uh-oh. Don't eat me. The ninth little caterpillar fell into the sea. Ooh, there's a big fish. The 10th little caterpillar scaled an apple tree. Scaled means he's going up the apple tree. What do you think the caterpillar is going to do in the apple tree? And hung there patiently. Do you see the caterpillar anymore? I don't see the caterpillar anymore, but look. Here is the tiger swallowtail chrysalis. A chrysalis is what the caterpillar goes into when he forms a hard outer shell. So the chrysalis is a hard outer shell. And the caterpillar is in the chrysalis changing to an adult. Say chrysalis. What do you think the caterpillar is going to look like when he comes out of the chrysalis? Think about what you know about caterpillars. Until by and by, the 10th little caterpillar, I see him peeking out of the chrysalis. I wonder what's going to happen. Became a butterfly. Wow! So our caterpillar, let me see if I can go back. Our caterpillar climbed the apple tree, formed into his chrysalis, and emerged as a butterfly. Wow. Here are some more caterpillars, and some of them, like I said earlier, some of them turn into butterflies. So the morning cloak, the buckeye turns into a butterfly, but then some caterpillars turn into moths. So the cabbage looper turns into a moth. The yellow bear turns into the Virginian tiger moth. That's so neat. So let's talk a little bit more about caterpillars. There's a ton of different types, and they all, though, have similar qualities and lives. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna let you guys grab a piece of paper and something to write with, and I'm gonna turn my camera because we're going to do a word web. So go ahead and get a piece of paper and something to write with, and I'm gonna adjust my camera. And we're going to start a word web. So go ahead and pause the video, grab yourself a piece of paper and something to write with. All right, so now that you guys are back, we're going to start with our word web. And what we do in my classroom is we always start with writing our name. So go ahead and in the left corner, you're gonna write your name. So I'm going to write Ms. Hoffman. And in the right corner, we're going to write our date. So today is 3/23/2020. So it's 2020. And we're going to do our word web surrounding caterpillars, all about caterpillars. So in the middle of my paper, I'm going to write the word caterpillar. I'm going to do a rectangle. You can do a circle. You don't even have to put a shape around it, but I like to. And we're going to figure out 6 things that all caterpillars have in common. So we're going to do, just draw 6 lines. All right. And let's think about what we know and what we read in our story about caterpillars. So I know that all caterpillars go through a life cycle to become an adult. So I'm going to write the word life cycle. Okay. And so I want you to think, let's see, let's look through our book to see if we can think about what all caterpillars have in common. Let's start with looking at the cover. What do you notice is the same about all of our caterpillars? That's a good guess. They all have this, or a good answer. They all have similar body types. They all kind of look like worms or long ovals. So we're going to write body shape. We're going to write body shape. And I always encourage drawing. So if you want to draw a little picture of your caterpillar, you can. All right. And let's think. Let's think about what all of our caterpillars did in our story. This one crawled into a bower. This caterpillar wriggled up a flower. This one climbed a cabbage head. So what do they all do? They all, good job, they all wiggle or crawl to move about whatever food they're going to eat. So you can write that they move or wiggle. Objects. And I'm going to leave three of the spaces blank for you guys to fill out all by yourself. But I want you to think about what the caterpillars look like. I want you to think about what the caterpillars eat. What did they eat in the story? And we saw a couple of examples in the back, but what do all caterpillars turn into at the end of their life cycle? So I'm going to leave those three spaces blank for you, but I'm going to show you, zoom in, on what our word web looks like. We have our caterpillars in the middle. We said that they all have life cycles. They all have a similar body shape, and that they all move or wiggle up objects. So now you take your time to fill in the last three. And when you're done with those last three, send me a picture of it, or send your teacher a picture of your word web so that we know that you guys are paying attention and using those big brains of yours. And I'll see you guys tomorrow for our next read aloud. See you guys.